Welcome to Broadneck High School Baseball and our series, The Bruin Way. This video is chapter 2 in our video series, A Trip Around the Bases. This session is in the on-deck circle.
Also, another thing is if you're running at second base and you realize that the catcher only gives one sign, or the second sign is the pitch that we're going off of. We can start stealing signs, we'll be really good. Because it's a lot easier to hit when you know what's coming. And don't tell me, oh, coach, I don't like to know what's coming. There ain't one baseball player that doesn't like to know what's coming, as long as you guys can pick the signs correctly. Right? You give them the wrong sign, then you're in trouble. If you know what's coming, it's a heck of a lot easier to hit. Right? Now, in the hole, okay, you're getting yourself loose, you're timing out the pitcher. You get up here. Coach, you want to talk about on deck at all?
Yeah, but
you can go ahead.
So this, when actually in the hole and on deck, is the most important time to get your timing down. What we like to see is when a guy first gets out there and he's doing his in-between warm-up pitches in between innings, there should be five guys out here all together in unison.
Step in.
Getting a foot down. That is so intimidating. To see five guys on deck timing you up. Five. Okay? That's number one. All right, number two, when you're on deck and he's facing one of our guys, you should already know where his arm slot is, right? Because you watched him warm up in the bullpen. You know if he's a righty, lefty, you should know where his arm slot is, and you should know where the release point is, and you should know if it's just one release point or if it's one up here and then he drops down a little bit. Why is that important? Because you have to be able to shift your eyes to that release point when he gets to it, right? So you're looking at something fine, focusing on his eyes or his logo. When he gets to the release point, then your eyes should go from here to there. So you should know where that is, right? You should also watch the catcher, okay? Here's home plate. The catcher sets up like this down the middle most of the time, gives a sign. And then he goes, and if he doesn't move his glove, he just threw a ball outside, didn't he? Right? First pitch, outside. Next pitch, inside, right? So you try to develop patterns like Coach talked about. You try to see how many times that catcher goes like this on the first pitch and tries to go outside on you, right? So you can develop a pattern. Was it a strike? Was it a ball? Can he get his curveball over? Can he get his slider over? If every time he throws a curveball and the catcher's going like this, then don't ever swing at the curveball because he can't throw a first strike. Right? A lot of work needs to be done before you walk up to that plate. If you find out that he's throwing a fastball on the outside corner, first pitch, guess what? You better be hitting a line drive in that right center field gap. Don't get up there and do what Coach brought up and go, oh, it's outside. Boom. I'm going to take it. You know it's coming. Look for it and hit it that way. Right? He's not going to hit the inside corner that much. So that's where you start to develop your trends. Right here on deck. Okay? The other thing is, when you're on deck, you're the home plate coach. The most important job you got is you got to get the bat out of the way. As soon as if there's a runner that's in scoring position and that bat gets dropped, your job is to get it out of there. Sometimes the umpire will do it. You don't run into it. Make him mad. But it's your job. Without interfering in the play, get it out of the way. And then the next thing you do is you go back as far as you can. Help the guy coming in. Running in. Okay? Down, 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 down. Down outside. Down inside. Down outside, down inside. Why is that important? Because you're watching the ball. If the ball's over here, you're saying down inside, so he slides away from where the throw is. Okay? So you're the home plate coach, and you gotta verbalize, and you gotta be there helping him out. Don't tell him to get down at the last minute. When in doubt, tell him to get down early. He's halfway to home plate and it looks like it's going to be close. You're yelling down, 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 down. And when he hears that, he knows it's coming, right? He knows the ball's coming, or else you're not going to be telling him to get down. So he's going to hustle and get there. Okay?
Signs inside, outside, come on through, slide. That was, I don't want you to say you're up, you're up, you're up. Okay, I want you just to wave them in, score, score, score. Okay, because I don't want you to ever slow down. I want you to run hard all the way through home plate. Right, that's the only thing. Am I good with that?
Thank you for your interest in doing things the Bruin way. Please look for our other videos in this series, A Trip Around the Bases.